How do you do? How do you do? I know that there was a convention yesterday and everybody's excited about it, and there's pictures in all the papers about the drama, fantastic drama and excitement of the evening. It's so colorful and so brilliant, and everybody's talking about Michelle Obama saying such a touching, tender, beautiful speech, and her love for the country and her concern and her compassion for America. And they say it proves what a fantastically wonderful person she is now. She's dedicated to this country and what a great patriot she is. Why? Because she said so. Let me ask you a question. If you robbed a bank and you came back and you said, I didn't rob the bank, or I'm sorry I did, or I love banks, and you've made a whole speech exactly the opposite of what you did, would you say, well, if he made a speech, that's what he means and that's what he is, and you forget about anything he ever did? Would you do that? Let's be honest about it. She has made 100 different statements about how she can't stand this country.
For the first time in my adult lifetime, I'm proud of my country.
That it's only a good country since her husband was nominated, that it was a mean-spirited country. She even once made a speech about, once you're black in this country, you don't have a chance, because just when you think you're going further and further, they raise the bar higher and higher so you could never reach the bar level, and no matter what you do, you still fail because they make it impossible for you to ever develop anything or get anywhere. And that's what she said dozens and dozens of times. And why was she in that church for 20 years listening to somebody, a pastor, claiming that this is the worst country in the world and we gave AIDS and diseases to the black people? Why was she there for 20 years? If McCain was in a place where, like a Ku Klux Klan meeting, where for 20 years they were telling him how the black people are the worst people on earth, if all of a sudden McCain told you yesterday or tomorrow, you know something, I never believed that. I believe the black people are the best people on earth. Why were you in front of a Ku Klux Klan meeting for 20 years if the black people are the best? Just because I was there doesn't prove anything. Just because I heard these things all my life and I've been part of it and I've been listening to it and I've been there for 20 years as a partner in that kind of a story doesn't mean that I meant it, doesn't mean I felt it, doesn't mean I believed it. I make a speech now that I love the black people. If a guy from the Ku Klux Klan told you that all of a sudden when he was running for office and wanted a job, would you say, sure, you could tell he's a wonderful person. Look how he tells the truth. But the fact that for 20 years he believed and did all kinds of things that were exactly the opposite of what he's claiming doesn't count, because this woman can't lie. She's only looking for a job for the presidency. Why would she lie? It's impossible. It's not her nature. Just like her husband can't lie. Her husband had about 40 different excuses about why he was listening to that pastor for 20 years. First he never heard him, then he heard him but he wasn't listening, then he was listening but he didn't know he was there, then he didn't know how it happened. He had about 30 different excuses every different day. All of a sudden, in this business of politics, anybody could lie about anything because we have a morality level in politics that doesn't exist anyplace else. Senator Biden is a perfect example. In different debates, he said many different times that Barack Obama is unfit to be president. Once he called him intelligent, but not on that level. Like he's a high school boy looking for a man's job and he doesn't believe that he's inexperienced. Forget about him. Let me tell you what I believe, because I'm a guy who belongs to be president.
You were asked, is he ready? You said, I think he can be ready, but right now I don't believe he is. The presidency is not something that lends itself to on-the-job training.
I think that I stand by the statement.
So he looked upon him as some kind of an infantile kid, a child, an adolescent trying to look for a man's job. He put him like he was a moron. All of a sudden he says, this is the greatest man that ever happened, and this is the greatest president of our time. This is the same man, Biden, who's a total hypocrite and a fraud, not only about Obama, he's also a fraud and a hypocrite about McCain. Did you hear what he said about McCain? He said, oh, McCain is the greatest man. He's my friend, my partner. He said this for 20 years.
I would be honored to run with or against John McCain because I think the country would be better off.
I would be glad to be running with him, against him. I would be glad to be on any ticket with him. He's not only a wonderful person, but he's a great human being. He's a great minded thinker, a philosopher. He's a genius. Now, all of a sudden, McCain is the lowest. There's low people, but not like McCain. Where you find a low life like him, I don't know. He is a disgusting person. Ugh, I'm nauseous every time I look at him. I never liked him. I never heard him. I can't stand him, and I don't know what he's doing still alive in this country. Now, this is the sickness of our time. People who don't, if it was any other field but politics, and a guy contradicted himself every time he talked, would you listen to him? You would put him in a sanitarium. If you met him, you wouldn't want to go near him. You would say, there's the schmuck who lies every time he talks and contradicts himself every time he shows up. But if you're in politics, nothing matters. It's only the last thing you say that counts. If it contradicts everything you said and did all your life, it doesn't matter. They forget about it because look what a wonderful speech he made. Look what a wonderful speech she made. This Yenta, who hates this country all her life and said vicious, sick, obnoxious things about this country all her life, all of a sudden loves the country more than anybody. And the idiots of America say, look how true this is. You never read a paper before? Are you that moronic and stupid that you don't know anything about her all of a sudden? Did your mind go blank just because she made a speech? Did she mesmerize you to the point that you're hypnotized now and your mind stopped working? You're a schmuck if you believe her.
Let's stand together to elect Barack Obama, President of the United States of America. Thank you. God bless you, and God bless America.